Welcome to part two of the DevBytes series, Making Apps Beautiful. In this part, we're going to focus on the spacing and the typography of the list item as well as the detail view to make it look more beautiful. So let's just switch to our phone to see where we were up to at the end of the last part. And we'd modernized the app and had an action bar, gotten rid of the virtual navigation menu button, the legacy menu button. But you know, we look at this and the text isn't particularly well formatted, the images are an inconsistent size. When we go into the detailed view, the text is kind of going from edge to edge. There's still some glaring problems from a design point of view. And that's what we're going to look at fixing up in this part. So let's go back to the slides and let's see what we're going to try and achieve. The first thing we want to do is have a consistent set of heights for each of our list items. So we're using a 48 dip rhythm as per the Android design guidelines. So if we look at where we are now, this is actually what we want to be. So when we look at these slides now, you'll see that the line items, the list items are really nicely spaced out, and we've got some margins on either side of the detailed view as well. So let's look at how we do that in code. So switching over to code, we've specified a dimensions XML file. We want to abstract out the values that we're using as much as possible. So we've got an 8 dip vertical margin, which just basically means that on the text views, we're going to have an 8 dip margin above and below. And so the way we're going to do that is in this list item article, in our linear layout that contains our text views, we have this margin top and margin bottom defined. With our list item vertical margin. In the detail view for the fragment, we are also going to use a margin left and a margin right, and we're going to use that detailed horizontal margin, and that's what's going to give us the spacing on either side of that detailed view. So switching back to the slides, and you can see the kind of spacing that we're after. What we want to do is, once we've put those dimensions in, we also want to now fix up the spacing with the thumbnails. And basically what we want to do here is eliminate that inconsistency that we have from thumbnail to thumbnail. The way we're going to do that is use the center crop attribute on the image view and set the scale type. So that way it's nice and consistent from each image to image. The next thing we want to do is focus on the typography. So if you look at the image on the left, the fonts, they're okay. They're not particularly attractive. You can see very much on the right-hand side that we've paid a lot of attention to detail there and made some really good changes. So let's look at what we did there. We're going to look at the two main text views. The top one is the title and then the subtitle in each list item. So you'll see that we've used a condensed font and made it bold for the title. For the subtitle, we've actually changed the color of the text so that it contrasts less. And you may want to abstract that out too. And we've also made it all caps. The other thing you want to look at is the fact that with both of these, we've actually fixed the number of lines, and we've used this property called ellipse size, which will basically truncate the text and put dot, dot, dot if it's going past that maximum line specification. So it's just presented in a nice, consistent manner from item to item. So if we now look at the detail page, the other thing that we want to do is make the author stand out a lot more. What we're going to do is use this property called text color link. That text color link is actually a property on the text view, and we've just used this bacon color. Again, on the text views, all you do is add that one property, your links will stand out. But that also means that we need to make that author at that top subtitle a link as well. So the way we're doing that is actually for that part, we're doing it programmatically. Where in onCreateView, we go and fetch the font color, and when we're going to put the author in that text view, we just put some HTML on either side to specify the font color. The other thing that we'll see that we're doing here is that for the article body as well, where we're using a custom font that we've shipped with our APK. So, just getting to our checkpoint, if you see on the left-hand side, that's where we started. We've come a long way. It's a really beautiful app on phones now. So join me for the next part for focusing on tablets.